Okay, let's talk a little bit about the living room in the old house. This is pretty much the way it looked when I bought it. It was brown and yellow and black. And that ceiling that looks brown was actually painted white, but I guess the people must have smoked because the ceiling had turned brown. And if you look at those walls, you can see where the photos had hung on the walls and the smoke had stained all around the picture frames, so you could still see the outlines of the picture frames in the smoke. Now, I don't know if they smoked cigarettes that much or if they had the chimney hooked up wrong, which I think might have been possible, because when I pulled the wood stove out, it didn't look like it was exactly right. But hey, that had to go. I mean, you know, that was just depressing to look at that, you know, chocolate brown and yellow and black and smoke stain. And that fan overhead, that's kind of interesting. If you look at that white streak out to the side, what they did was they put a piece of wood on the ceiling, they bolted that fan to it, they ran a wire along that white streak, and they put a piece of wood over it, and then ran the wire down and plugged it into the wall. That was the way they wired the fan. And that white streak is the old paint underneath that wasn't smoke stained, so you can see that there was a lot of smoking going on there. Well, anyway, I took the fan out. I saved it. I reused it somewhere else. But when I pulled the fan down, a good part of the ceiling came down with it. Looked to me about to be a hole in the plaster about the size of an alligator up there, and had that old knob and tube wiring hanging out of it. So I had to fix that, which was really quite a process. I mean, this was kind of my first go. Oh, I thought I'd show you the wiring here. That's pretty good looking wiring for that fan there. But anyway, for me, it was all about painting and, you know, trying to turn those walls white, which took an awful lot of coats of paint. While I was at it, I also pulled the windows out. A lot of them were broken, but all of them had the caulking had crystallized and fallen apart. So I re-caulked them and repainted them and cleaned them up and fixed the broken glass. And then I had to turn my attention to this ceiling up here. And basically, boy, don't those white walls look good. Yes, sir. Anyway, where was I? Oh, yeah, I was fixing the ceiling. And basically what I did was, where that big hole was, I actually just put a little sheet of plywood that was about as thick as the plaster, and then mixed up some more plaster and just plastered it up there. I am not a stickler for absolutely flat surfaces in a house this old. I know that nowadays we think that if a sheetrock wall has a tape mark on it or a dimple where a nail went in, oh my lord, that's just not acceptable. But if you look at old houses, I think a lot about old European houses, none of them have straight walls. In an old house, the old walls, the texture of the old walls give them character. So I didn't try to make this perfect, I just tried to make it good. Oh, by the way, this lamp I found at a yard sale, I thought it was just a honking beautiful thing. I hung it up there where that old fan used to be. And I put a plug-in up top there. I don't know if you can see it in any of these pictures, but rather than mounting that lamp in there permanently, I just put a plug-in in there, put a little hook on there. It hangs by a chain, and I just plug it right in. That way, if I ever want to change it, it won't be much trouble to change. Some people look up there and they see that plug-in and they think, well, ain't that odd? Never seen a plug-in in the ceiling before, but you know, it's quite functional, don't hurt anything, and if I ever want to change it, it's be pretty easy to hang a regular light fixture from it. Anyway, you can see with paint that the ceiling started looking pretty good. I trimmed up that chair rail and hung some curtains and put a little furniture in there, and man, that's, I think you'll have to admit, that's quite a difference from what we started out with. I also mounted a little TV up in that box there. Of course, I changed all this later. I actually took the TV back out. I don't watch much TV. This is a before and after shot right here. This is after, before and after. And let's do this again. Before. Ooh, ain't that ugly. And after. You gotta admit, after is better. I like that a whole lot. Y'all have a nice day.